Qatium is a SaaS platform. So we are, our mission really is to make digital water management available to all utilities, big and small. We really emphasized on the last two words, and small, right? So today I'm going to talk a little bit more about flushing and use cases and what can we do with Qatium. We really want to empower everyone out there, all the operators, all the water professionals out there to get access to digital tools and to be able to get great insights from data that you probably already have. So that's really one key thing at Qatium, is trying to ensure that we provide you something that is helpful, useful in your daily operations. So just to go back to the basics a little bit, right? So what does Qatium do? So we really want to be an easy to use water management platform. So the first step would be to digitalize, right? So create a digital twin, so to speak, of your water network. So not only for creating scenarios and connecting live data and combining different sources of data like hydraulic models, GIS data, and so on, but also just to have an overall view, a holistic view of your network, understand what is happening, when it's happening, and so on. Obviously, allowing that model and that digitization to allow you to optimize your operations. So being able to run scenarios, I quickly mentioned it just before, but so being able to answer what if questions, right? So what happens if I close a valve? What if happens if I isolate a pipe, an asset, pump, tanks, whatever it may be? What if I change the setting of a PRV pump, PRV valve, pressure regulation valve, right? How is that going to impact my DMA, my area that is regulated by that valve? And also more deeply, is it impacting my network in other areas that I'm not maybe not really looking into, but actually it has a kind of a snowball effect that it basically propagates issues across your network. So being able to understand what is happening, optimize your daily, weekly operations, or just recurring operations, right? Today we're going to talk about flushing. And finally, customizing, right? So really, one of the things that we want to do with Qatium is to be able to tailor our platform to you. So we are now a platform, and I'll talk a little bit about more later on the presentation. But really, the idea is to understand what is your problem. What are you trying to solve as a water utility, as a consultant, as an operator, as a water professional, and whether we actually can find something that is available to you inside Qatium. So repeating a little bit what I just said, right? So we want to do that for all utilities. This is really critical, critical mission of Qatium. We want to help all utilities of all sizes. So just to give you an idea, so we're partnering and having customers in the UK, which counts one of the largest utilities around the globe, right? So utilities that are serving millions of people, but also that would also have, for example, a staff that's is 5,000 people, which are actually larger than our smallest customer, right? So our smallest customer are below 2,000 inhabitants population, like water utilities in the US, for example. And so being able to serve water utilities of all sizes and to be able to answer everyone's need is really at the core of what Qatium wants to do, whether it's through streamlining processes, operations, and flushing, like we're going to see today. So I mentioned it already a couple of times. Today we're going to talk about flushing sequences, but it's not the only thing we do in Qatium, right? So we do flushing, but we do water main shutdown. If you have missed our previous webinar, we talked about managing tanks in terms of emergency. So talking about tank autonomy, don't hesitate to go back and watch the recording. But what we also do is manage demand, fire flow, system pressures, and also our real-time hydraulic modeling. So all of this within one platform. And this is, I want to say, the tip of the iceberg. We want to be able to provide some more, whether it's use cases that we create at Qatium. And again, having that platform that I'm going to mention a little bit later is going to be critical to that, for that perspective. But without any further ado, let's dive into flushing in Qatium. What does that mean and what can we do? So I am going to just do a recap of Qatium. I know that some of you were already there on the previous webinar. So I'm going to do a very quick recap on what are we seeing, what is Qatium all about, and then we're going to dive a little bit deeper into the flushing, right? So Qatium, as you can see, it's a map-based interface. So here we can see a map. So we're actually located on the east coast of Australia, my favorite network in Qatium. I say that to the bottom of my heart. Really, really, really insane island, really pretty. If you ever had a chance to go, please do. Here in the model, so we have some data that you can see here. We have some polygons to represent the DMAs. If I zoom in a little bit, you can see that we have many more assets. So we have some pipes, some valves, some tanks, and more. So just to give you an overview once more, all your assets here in Qatium are visible on the map, and you can actually interact with them. So just deactivating the zone just for the purpose of the demo, you can see here that we have different types of views. And again, selecting asset, being able to interact with them, and so on, being able to find details, being able to see simulation values. So Qatium is showing results from a hydraulic modeling, hydraulic simulation. What does it do? What is the benefit of that is to be able to run scenarios and to really get as much in the details as we want, but also to also have a high level view and a very easy to use interface that allows anyone to be able to use Qatium and get some valuable insights. So I started with showing you basically the assets, but you can very easily get some very clear insights about pressure. So thinking about customer pressure, thinking about the flows. So I'm just going to activate and deactivate panels here on the right-hand side just to show you around a little bit. So those flows are actually part of the result that we get from the simulation. The water is genuinely moving that way. So we're gathering here synthetic live data. So we're in for demo purposes. And we're actually running a live model. So all of this is what really happens in the network. I won't go through every single functionality, but please, if you're interested in knowing about Qatium, we're a freemium platform. So just go to qatium.com, sign up, try the application for yourself. You basically will get the exact same model that I'm showing you right now, minus or two few tweaks, and you'd be able to experience most of the functionalities. And after, I'll invite you that if you want to learn more, contact our sales team, and we will make sure to get you started in Qatium, and so on. I've been talking enough about the interface, whether it's the map, the functionality. I'll be going to the demo. So here we are in the same network. I've just switched to some US units. before it was the original network in Australia. Here is just the same network. The only difference is that it's US units. So talking about GPM for flows and talking about PSI for pressures. How do you do a flushing in Qatium? So the first thing that you do when you want to do a flushing in Qatium is that you go to the work mode. So we created the work modes to simplify even further the experience of Qatium, so you don't have to open multiple panels, click at multiple places, but just go to the work mode, select flushing, and you can see that the app is changing on its own and putting itself in a mode for you to consume that information to get the best insights out of it. I am going to do my flushing around 4 a.m. So I simply have to select that time step in the timeline. And the next thing that I'm going to do is simply select a hydrant. I'm going to select a hydrant and I'm going to go all blazing on it and just increase the flow on that hydrant. So virtually opening it, and I'm going to go about mid-range of that available flow. And so we can see here that already things are changing inside the application, and we can already try to understand what is happening. So here, what we see is that we've actually opened the hydrant up to 723 gallons per minute. We have a residual pressure of 70 PSI, and we already can see that we're getting some optimal velocities in the network. So all the flows are converging. You can see from the animation that all the flows are converging to the hydrant. And that in that case, everything is green. So what does green mean? We reach optimal velocity. What is optimal velocity, you ask? Optimal velocity in Qatium is going to be 5 feet per second. And we also calculate or try to give you an idea of the discoloration risk. So we can see here that even though we're reaching that optimal velocity in those pipes, we're actually having a suboptimal velocity in those orange pipes, and we might have some discoloration risk. And the reason that we might get some discoloration risk is either that the flow was very low before the start of the flushing, which might mean that this is an area where you potentially have a lot of sedimentation. And so all this might be moved across when you do the flushing and when everything comes through. But you can also see it as potentially a risk of discoloration in other parts of the network, right? So right now we're really in the vicinity, in the close area, close to where we're doing that flushing. But you can also think about it as a broader indicator of change in velocity, maybe something that you want to investigate in your network to be able to understand a little bit more what is happening, how come you might have some more calls for discolored water in one part of the network or the other. And so this gives you a better understanding of all that. But Qatium allows you to go a little bit deeper than that. So within that flushing possibility, depending on your goal, so we're going to set ourselves our goal, right? So we want to flush actually that line that is going from the northeast and going through the curve here. So we're going to say, okay, well, actually, I'm not trying to flush this area. So let's try to go closer to unidirectional flushing, right? So the concept of unidirectional flushing is pretty simple in the sense that it's basically forcing the water to go in one direction. So we're focusing all the flow to come from one area, so we don't have to open the hydrant that much. So we can test it out and reduce that flow. So I'm going to lower it down to 420. And I can see directly that very quickly, Qatium runs another simulation. Valve is closed. Hydrant has changed value for opening. And actually, it's great for one part of the area that we wanted to flush, but not the other one. So we can then decide to increase it slightly and kind of find that optimal value or reevaluate previous flushing value, considering that now we actually can test it when the valve is closed. So that's one example here. I would like to show you another example. So I'm going to delete that scenario. So by clicking here on the left-hand side in the little paper bin, and this is going to remove, and I'm going to go back to my base network. So here we're more in a, I want to say neighborhoody area. So if I switch on my satellite view, you can see that it's mainly houses all around. I'm going to just stay in the dark mode because I think it probably feels better when watching it through a webinar. And I'm going to do exactly the same thing. So I'm going to select a hydrant. I am going to increase that flow, and I'm going to try to reach that velocity. And in that case, it's the opposite. It's, we're actually starting to get very low pressure. So probably there's no way to get my whole network or that whole area that I want to flush to get it all in the green. So instead of trying to open more and more my hydrants, what I'm going to do is beforehand, I am going to try to make the flow go in a single direction. So I'm closing valve little by little. You can tell that the flow animation is helping me quite a bit to understand how can I make sure that my flow is going in a single direction. And I can see that even with that reduced flow value and that hydrant, I can still get some pipe in the green. So optimal velocities for flushing again. And I can see and try different options and evaluate all the sequences. So that's a little bit of how you do flushing inside Qatium. But with that capability is also other, this is combined with all of the rest that you have in Qatium. So you can combine this with customer pressure. The flows are already activated, but I really like to compare before and after. How am I impacting the customer pressure? So I can even filter down. So I might be interested in looking at only customer points that are below 30 PSI and see what is the impact on my whole network, in my DMA, and so on and so forth. So I can see that here I only actually have 2 points, which are very obvious that I'm actually flushing, that are getting below 30 PSI, but I can also look at 40, under 45, under 60, and so on and so forth. And to really focus on trying to provide the least impact to the user. And that's it. That's all, folks. I will move back to the presentation, and I think that we'll be able to hopefully address a couple of questions at the end. So going back to Qatium as a platform, and how do we actually build things for our users, or how do we let what makes Qatium a platform? It's the SDK. So what does SDK mean? Is software development kits. It's the basis of Qatium in the sense of we're allowing ourselves, because we're drinking our own champagne and using the SDK ourselves, to build on top of it to make sure that what we set up as a platform is useful for us internally and externally. And we do that by allowing external developers, so it could be casual coders, it could be students, postdocs, it could be professors, but also other utilities, so especially large utilities that have those capabilities of coding and creating plugins on top of Qatium, customizing the way Qatium feels, look, what type of insights it provides, really customize it to their region of the world, their view of the water management. but also partners. So we also have partners, integration partners that are building connectors. So for example, from a SCADA or AMI interface to Qatium in order to feed that information into Qatium. And also other partners that might have a leak detection module or might have a leak detection algorithm that they would like to offer to all the users inside Qatium, or you want to benefit from these insights that Qatium gets by being a water management platform and extend the offering and build on top to be able to offer greater insights. And that's it. That was all for me. Yara, I don't know if there was any questions.
Yeah, let's I'll just pop up the questions here up on the screen, David. So here's the first one.
So can Qatium do different types of flushing? That's quite interesting. So depending on where you are in the world, you're probably more or less familiar with different types of flushing, and you probably do them on a different basis, whether it's on a regular basis or whether it's a little bit more on demand, preventive, and around operations and so on. But anyway, so we do have actually users that have been using Qatium for mains conditioning, which is another type of flushing, which is basically ensuring that the pipe can transport a certain amount of water, clean water, without any too much trouble. So yes, the flushing inside Qatium is pretty open to any types of flushing that basically is opening a hydrant or increasing the flow at a point in the network and being able to see all the insights from it. So yeah, definitely. I see that there was another one, which was, do you have users using this module? So yes, we do. I just mentioned one, right? But we do have users a little bit everywhere around the world. Sorry, whether it's in the US, in the UK, or even in Australia. So just to give you a little bit of context, when I say all around the world, it's literally all around the world. And again, like I said, different types of flushing. Sometimes not everyone is doing mains conditioning. Not everyone is doing unidirectional flushing. Not everyone is interested in the same thing, whether it's talking about water quality, whether it's talking about the capacity of the network to transport water, whatever, you know. But yes, we do have different people are all across the world using Qatium for that. I'm not sure how much time we have. I see that there's a bunch of questions coming in, and I'm really happy to answer them. Maybe one last one, considering the time. Is it possible for the platform to create work orders from flushing sequences? So the answer is sadly not no. But I prefer the answer not yet. So like I mentioned at the end, we're a platform, we're building integrations, we're increasing our number of plugins and integration within our marketplace. So probably soon, but stay tuned and let us know what kind of work order system you're using, what kind of CMMS you would like us to connect to. Feel free to make introductions. Feel free to just tell them to introduce themselves to us. We love to collaborate on making Qatium more popular, obviously, but also being able to provide a more complete solution to the water utility out there. So,
And then, David, one last question in the chat, actually, from Eduardo. What are the consequences of doing flushing operations without a tool like Qatium?
Yes. So I think that it's just like the lack of awareness, right? So is the first one that comes to mind for me. It's just you might have been, a lot of water utilities have planned their flushing schedule. And I've been talking to one who has been, they've been planning flushing schedule since, like, I don't know, more than 40 years ago, which is quite impressive. But it's always good to have a check-in, right? So the flushing schedule that you might have, you know, last year, 5 years ago, whether it's in-house, whether it's a contractor that actually came up with that flushing sequence, the network might have changed, the demand, you know, your population has grown or reduced. And so where your water used to be really demanded, and so a high flow, now it might be actually getting old and stale. So being able to understand where are the critical areas of your network, and being able to actually understand, okay, is my flushing schedule answering my needs? Is it keeping my customers safe? Am I protecting my network and my customers doing those sequences, or is there a better option out there? Am I wasting too much water? And that, now we go into more like the ROI and, like, you know, cost of water, and also, you know, trying to be environmentally and drought conscious, especially in some parts of the world. So all those questions are quite some of the things that are really important to nail down, that without a tool like Qatium, like, you probably are still wandering from time to time.
Perfect. Thank you. I think we're going to wrap it up now. So thank you so much to everyone for joining. Let me just turn my camera on here real quick. Thanks so much to everyone for joining. As I said, if you did join a little bit later, just so that you are aware, we have one of these webinars every month where we walk you through a different Qatium use case on each one. We also have community webinars every month. We have one coming up now, actually, on the 13th of June, where we are going to have one of our Qatium experts, Nusha Ajami. She's the Chief Strategy and Development Officer for Research at Berkeley Lab. And she's going to be presenting a session on how we can successfully redesign the role of water in future cities. So that's going to be a great event. If you do want to keep updated with all of this, feel free to join our Slack community, qatium.com/community. You can sign up there and stay up to date with what we're doing. You can also watch back all of these webinars in our community. We have a dedicated channel in there where, you know, a week and a half after these webinars, we drop the full recording in there as well. So thank you so much to everyone who joined. Thanks, of course, David, for the brilliant presentation. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you very much. Don't hesitate to reach out and to join Qatium.